Western boundary currents form a part of the ocean gyre system. These gyres, which are primarily wind-driven, circulate water throughout the ocean basins. The areas of these currents considered boundary currents occur where they run parallel to the coastlines of large landmasses, with western boundary currents forming on the western boundaries of a given ocean basin. Western boundary currents have two main characteristics. They're warm and they're fast. These currents run from the equator towards the poles, transporting warm water from low latitudes to high latitudes. Furthermore, because of physics properties that I don't understand, western boundaries act as marine highways along our coasts. Our own East Australian current flows up to speeds of 4 knots and can be as narrow as 15 kilometres. In order to explore tropicalisation along western boundary currents, we must distinguish the difference between tropical vagrancy and tropicalisation. Due to the properties of western boundary currents, they are very good at transporting marine larvae from the tropics towards the subtropics. Because marine organisms are highly adapted to specific water temperatures, tropical larvae carried by western boundary currents are only able to settle in temperate waters during summer periods. However, as these waters cool off during winter, so do the tropical vagrants. And they all die. This defines tropical vagrants in that they don't make a permanent impact on the ecosystem, only occurring during specific times of the year. But now we have climate change. Intensification of the wind systems that drive ocean gyres has thus made western boundary currents strong. Western boundary currents are thus some of the fastest warming areas of the ocean on the planet, with sea surface temperatures along western boundary currents warming at a rate of 2 to 3 times greater than that of the average. As winter minimum temperatures are now becoming higher and higher, tropical vagrants that once weren't able to survive the winter months are now able to persist. What we are currently observing is being coined as tropicalization, where what were once temporary vagrant species, now establishing permanent populations in temperate areas and modifying those habitats towards more tropical systems. The increase in year-round pressures on temperate ecosystems caused by strengthened western boundary currents have led to the decline of these environments. The Kuroshio Current, which passes along the coast of Japan, and the East Australian Current, which passes along Australia's east coast, have clear examples of this process occurring. In Japan, within an area known as Tosa Bay, what were once kelp beds have become replaced with acropora corals, with persistent year-round assemblages of tropical marine fish. Similarly, this is occurring along Australia's east coast, with a small coral reef found in 2014 as far down as Sydney, being comprised of subtropical Psyllopora corals. But how does the persistent presence of tropical marine larvae translate to ecosystem replacement? Tropical herbivores such as rabbitfish, surgeonfish, and tropical sea urchins, which are now able to overwinter in temperate zones, continually consume seaweed and algal turf, reducing both existing macroalgae and recruits. When this seaweed or algal turf has been reduced to bare substrate, this allows for organisms such as stony corals to settle, which require bare substrates in order to metamorphose. Furthermore, the warmer sea surface temperatures themselves impact the recovery rate of seaweed species, where they reduce recovery capacity and fertility. The change in marine benthos composition from temperate to tropical also has the effect of attracting more fish assemblages, with reef species that can actually inhabit these corals coming to use them. This is most exemplified in the range expansions of clownfish along the East Australian coast, with the abundance of clownfish at Fish Rock being limited by the availability of anemones. Because anemones are key to the life history of these fishes, the lack of anemones at this location mean they haven't been able to settle as successfully as in locations just further north, such as North and South Solitary Islands. And now a quick speedrun of all the effects of tropicalization because I want to go to the pub.
Increased dive tourism.
Loss of commercial fish stocks.
Hollywood habitat compression.
Changes to carbon flux.
Getting stung by a box jellyfish in Sydney.
Upside down jellyfish in Lake Macquarie.
Coral reefs escaping coral bleaching.
Greater structural complexity in temperate ecosystems.
And we're done.